Hi, I'm Shelby. I'm a sophomore from Marian. My poem is titled Stardust. We are pieces of stardust and iron and just as full of mysteries as the rest of the universe. Fire burns in our souls brighter than anything we have ever seen before or seen. We can burn hot and cold and all sorts of different colors, humming at frequencies that only certain ears can hear. So don't worry if nobody can hear you now, because I can, and I'm listening. One day you will be the thing that somebody wishes upon, and then you will be heard for the rest of eternity. Wait. I have waited a very, very long time, and honestly, I'm still waiting, but I believe that one day somebody will see just how brightly we shine, and they will wish for their future. Don't be upset if not everybody who sees you sees your beauty, because not everybody appreciates eternal beauty like yours. When they look at me, they see a 4'10" body of flesh and bone. They don't see the stars behind my eyes. But the person who sees it in you, they will see the universe in your eyes, because that is what you are. Even your speckles or your birthmarks or your scars, they form the most beautiful constellation across your body. And don't you get hate when people throw rocks at your beauty. I've got beauty too. They're not as dark as they used to be, but they are still there. Did you know? In their pure forms, oxygen is toxic, and nitrogen is so cold that it burns. We breathe those in. Does it really surprise you? We need them to survive. And when the world turns away from you, it is just giving more of us the opportunity to have your light in our lives. If that is too much and you can't handle anything else, fall into yourself, collapse, but do so with the knowledge that you are not going to die. Because stars are born from collapsing. Stars are born when all of that dirt and dust and toxic oxygen and cold gas get compressed so tightly together they have nowhere to go but out. They have nothing to do but erupt. So by all means, collapse, erupt, explode. Just know you are still the most beautiful thing I have ever seen.